Hi there, I'm Michelle. Welcome to my studio. Today we're going to be shooting a really gentle class. This is just to help you get rid of the aches and pains that come with pregnancy. I recommend for first trimester that you find a practitioner, someone who teaches yoga within your community, or even just take it easy. It's a part of your life that it's best just to really rest and take really good care of yourself. But if you're in second or third trimester and the doctors gave you the A-okay, then feel free to practice with me at home. Just take it super easy. Don't push anything too hard. All right, so we're just going to start by warming up our wrists. We're going to come into tabletop position. Your knees are going to be right underneath your hips. Your toes are going to tuck under, and you're going to try and get a really good grip on those toes. You're going to push the toe prints into the floor. Knees and feet are hips distance apart. I like to have my wrists slightly ahead of my shoulders, pushing into my fingers and my palms. Some of you, if you feel the wrists here, you may want to walk the hands even further forward. If you still feel your wrist, then that's a sign that you need to use blocks and just put blocks or something a little bit higher that you can squeeze underneath your hands. So pressing into your fingers, pressing into your palms, we're going to exhale to curl the spine like an angry catlet. And then with the shoulders back, we're going to take an inhale. We're not going to go all the way into the back bend. I want you to watch that you don't go all the way into the back. So you try and keep this quite stable. We're just opening the chest more. So again, we're not dropping the belly, but it's almost like you're lifting the belly up just a little bit and opening the chest. Exhale to curl the spine, think angry kitty, pushing the floor away. And then inhaling, shoulders back, sit bones lift, easing up. Going back and forth. Exhaling into your kitty. And then inhaling, shoulders back, sit bones lift, gazing up, back and forth. You can get nice and deep into your cat, but as you come forward into that cow, into that back bend, just be very gentle. If you're still feeling your wrists, you can always come down onto your elbows. Stopping with a nice straight spine, nice big inhale to lengthen. And then point the feet, we're going to push the tops of the feet into the floor and just almost feel like you're pulling the toes to you to lift the ankles just a little bit. Then we're going to make hip circles. So keeping your back nice and straight and just taking those hips into big slow circles. Try not to move your feet or your knees if you can help it. Making sure you're always breathing. Like I said earlier, really being gentle on yourself. Pregnancy is a time to do a lot less than what you're used to doing. It's a time just to be gentle and allow the body to change naturally. And changing direction with your circles. Nice gentle hip opener, starting to create strength in your shoulders for those long days of carrying and feeding to come. Take five more breaths here.
Then when those 5 breaths are complete, push into your arms to come up, back into tabletop position, coming forward onto your knees, bring those knees together, and just gently opening up the backs of the knees, pushing the toes into the floor as you straighten out your leg. Be careful not to pop into the back of the knee, but really think about the calf moving towards the floor so the knee isn't being compromised at all. There's a really strong tendency to hyperextend our knees. And then opposite leg will straighten. Push into the toes, take those toes as far away from you as you can as you straighten out your leg. Again, push into your fingers and your palms. You don't want to feel your wrists. Index fingers are always pointing straight forward. Fingers spread wide. Then from here, we're going to come onto our seats. We're going to lengthen those legs out in front of us. If you have a hard time finding your sit bones, you can always take a blanket or two and just pop that underneath your seat. And that little bit of height will make this kind of thing a little bit easier. So do what you need to do. We're going to bend the right knee. We're going to take the right foot on the outside of the left leg, making sure the sole of the right foot is on the floor, pushing down. So if you need to move the foot away from you, you can. And then the left foot, the heel is centered, and there's a straight line from the big toe to heel. So the knee is pointing right up towards the sky. We're going to interlace our fingers over that right shin. Nice big inhale to lengthen. Try and relax your neck and your shoulders. There should be no tension there. Right hand stays where it is. Left hand's going to come behind you. And we're just going to very, very gently twist to the left. Try and keep the shoulders and armpits level as you twist. And for some of us, that arm may come to the inside. You make a 90 degree angle. And you can just very gently root the arm into the leg as you keep twisting. And then eventually the gaze will turn. Keeping that left heel centered, keeping the arms nice and active, just creating space for baby as you start to open up the upper back. Nice deep, full breaths here. Back to center when you're ready. Interlace your fingers. Big inhale to lift the chest. I like to keep my right hand on my right knee to remind me it's a hinge. It only moves one way. And I really think about pivoting at the hip socket, ball and socket joint of the hip. That's where you want to pivot. So right hand on right knee. Bring that left hand behind you. With that left hand behind you, you're just going to start to bend that left knee, dragging the heel to you. Right ankle is going to hook on the outside of the left knee. Really activate both feet. Maybe both hands come down. Start with the fingers pointing back. Maybe you can drag the heel to you so the sole of the foot is down. If that heel stays there, that's fabulous. Just keep the feet active. Okay, we don't want this to tuck into the knee at all. If the sole of the foot comes down, then the option is keeping a straight back to start to bring your seat towards your foot. So just nice and slow, working your seat forward. Watch the shoulder heads don't come forward. You're doing enough of that when you're nursing this little one. So make sure you're working those shoulder heads back and sliding the armpits forward. Fingers back is going to be most gentle on the wrist. A little bit of a bend in the elbow will also soften the stretch on the wrist. But if you're looking for more of a wrist stretch, the options are to bring the fingers to point to the side or to have the fingers to point forward. Okay, that will increase the stretch. The more you straighten the arms, the more the wrists will be stretched. So again, soften it by bending the elbows. Again, you can just take it to wherever you like. Heart center lift, shoulders back, feet are active. I like to just close my eyes and really focus on breathing. Feel the weight even in the seat. Often the weight goes to the right side or the left side, but you want to keep the weight even in the seat. And again, no shoulders back. You're going to lose the hip release the minute you do that. You'll lose the back release. Then when you arrive, just really focusing on your breath. Again, if it starts to creep into the wrist, adjusting the position of the wrist so it's comfortable. There should never be any pain in yoga. This is a great pose to prep for birth. Something you can do even while watching TV. Most of us need to have a little bit of a warm-up, some of the stuff that we did previous to be able to do this pose, especially if you want to hold it for longer periods of time. It's definitely an aid to pregnancy. really helps with back, hip, shoulder pain. And then when you're ready, you walk your hands back, you walk your seat back, and then reminding yourself that the knee is a hinge, use your hand to support the knee, make sure you're pivoting at the hip as you straighten out the legs. Nice. When straightening the legs in pregnancy, you always want to keep those feet a little bit apart, just giving your pelvic floor a little bit of space. Coming to the other side, we're going to bend the left knee. We're going to take the left foot outside the right. Making sure the entire sole of that left foot is on the floor. Remember, you can always walk it away from you if you need to. If it's on the floor, you can always have it on its own side as well. Center of the right heel is on the floor. Straight line from big toe to heel. We're going to interlace our fingers. This time, left hand over right because we're doing the left side. Big inhale to lift the chest. Shoulder heads back. Shoulders relax. Neck relax. Left hand stays where it is to support the back and keep it straight. Right hand comes behind you. Keeping the shoulders and the armpits level, we just start the journey of the twist. If it's available, the elbow can come to the inside of that knee. Watch that it doesn't change the shoulder or the back. And then really finding that external rotation of the arm, almost like you're rooting into the back of the hand. Get a 90 degree angle on the elbow as you twist a little deeper. And then maybe the gaze comes behind you. Again, keeping on your palms. I sometimes like to feel my fingers to strengthen them, but palm is great. Really finding both feet pressing into them. Big, beautiful breaths. Really think about the armpits lengthening up, the shoulders relaxing. Then unwinding back to center. Once again, we're going to interlace our fingers over the shin. Inhale to lift and lengthen. Lots of space for that baby if the spine is lengthening. Left hand supports the left knee to remind it it's a hinge. Bring your hand behind you. Make sure you're pivoting at the ball and socket joint inside the hip as you just bend that right knee and drag that heel to you. Really activate your feet. Activate your legs. Bring both hands behind you. Maybe if the sole of the foot comes down, you can use your hands to move your seat forward. Shoulders don't come forward, they stay back. Straight spine. See how my ears are right over my shoulders and I'm not turtlenecking. Again, just walking those feet. Feet stays walking the seat forward. And again, you can rotate your fingers if you want to work the wrist stretch a little bit, with a bend in the elbows to soften it. Fingers out to the side, whatever feels appropriate for you. Push into your feet, push into your seat, and lift your armpits forward as you relax the neck and shoulders. Gaze is forward, close your eyes, and just breathe in here. Smooth, even breaths. Really using this opportunity to become connected with your breath. Be able to follow the inhalation and follow the exhalation. That'll come in handy in labor. Slowing down your heart rate by slowing down your breath. By breathing in and out through the nose, the brain automatically receives the message that the body is receiving oxygen, and the brain then relaxes, which allows the muscles to relax. When the muscles relax, things are more comfortable, including labor. Again, trying to match your sides evenly, and when you're done, make sure the fingers are pointing back as you move your seat back away from your foot until you have enough space to very carefully support the knee, pivot at the hip, and open up that leg. Again, fingertips beside you, just open up your heart, get your ears right over those shoulders, big, beautiful breaths. During pregnancy, it's a great idea just to really try and open the body this direction with that extra weight and life in general. We tend to come forward, and we're going to have a few months after of holding or nursing, and so that's going to bring us even more forward. So the more we think of shoulders back, armpits forward, align the ears over the shoulders, the more we build that foundation, the easier it's going to be once we're packing that baby around outside and on the inside. Alright, so from here we're going to come into a comfortable seated position. Supasana, or easy pose. right shin in front of the left shin. You can see that my knees are quite high, and the more I walk my feet towards the edges of the mat, the lower the knees come down, the closer the knees get, the better that's going to be for my hips and my knees. My feet are very active. If your knees are quite high here, then it's very important that you add enough height. So you can sit on a blanket or two blankets or three blankets, however many blankets you need, so that eventually you want your knees to be lower or level with your hips. All right? So feet are active, pressing down, push into your hands, shoulders back, heart center lift, sit up nice and tall. We're then going to bring our fingers to our shoulders. We're going to hold onto the shoulders, just very gently squeeze them. As if it was like a piece of fruit and we were checking to see if it was ripe, but we didn't want to pierce the peel. And then we're going to start with big, slow circles. Again, really focusing on your breath. Making those circles as big and as slow as you can. And trying not to move your torso too much. Pushing your seat down, pushing your feet down. And then changing direction with those circles. Big, slow backward circles. Continuously just squeezing those shoulders a wee little bit. This series is called the Thoracic Park Series, and it's great prep for babies and mamas. And then stopping with those backward circles, we're going to exhale to bring the elbows to touch. We're going to inhale to take the elbows apart. Exhale to bring the elbows to touch, and inhale the elbows apart. Again, you can rest anytime you like. If you want the elbows to be a little bit lower, they can, but ideally they're up level with the shoulders. Then taking the elbows apart, the shoulders high, exhale to bring the elbows down, inhale to bring them straight up. Listening to your knees and your hips and your back. If at any point you start to feel them, you can straighten one or two legs and still do the same series. You could even do this series sitting on your knees, your shins, or even on a chair. Do what you have to do. And then bringing those elbows up with the shoulders. Keep the elbows at a shoulder's height. Reach them away from you. Let's take our wrists over our elbows. Make nice fists. Feel like you're karate chopping with the forearms. So you've got these nice 90-degree angles. Exhale to bring the forearms down. Inhale to bring them up. And the fists never drop below the elbows. I know this is harder than it looks. But again, such great preparation. We're packing around a little one. And keep those nice fists. Feel like you're karate chopping the fists away from your body. Let's just do one more. And then bring those arms up to hold them up. Think about rooting into the backs of the hands, but keeping that 90-degree angle. Close your eyes and just build that strength. And then releasing those arms down, let your palms face up, close your eyes, and just breathing. Nice deep, full breath. Bend your elbow. That'll make it a little bit more mellow. on top of that hand. So we're sitting cross-legged with our hands like this. And gently, we want to think about moving these fronts of the shoulders, the shoulder heads back, and gently moving the armpits forward. And then we're just going to let that right ear come down towards the right shoulder. And then just rotate your chin. Gentle, gentle. Nice inhale to bring your chin back up to center. Let the opposite ear come down. Just gently rooting the backs of the hands. And then rotating your chin towards that shoulder. Chin comes back up to center, and then just dropping that chin straight down towards your chest. And then chin coming up. Good. Release your hands. Use your hands once again to support the knees as you lift those knees and uncross those legs. Take your feet nice and wide. If you're sitting on the floor, you can do the same pose with your feet nice and wide, hands coming forward, nice big inhale. Take a look at your knees and make sure your knees are going the exact same direction as those feet. The knees aren't wider than the ankles, the knees aren't more narrow than the ankles, but the knees are directly in line with the ankles. And then just lift up your toes so you're really pressing onto your feet. Fingers come forward, nice big inhale, and just start to walk those hands forward. Especially in the later trimesters, I find a little bit of height, you know, a couple blankets is really nice, and then you can kind of bring your feet in a little bit closer. It's just a wonderful low back release. Great hip opener, obviously. I'm just breathing into it. And then when you're ready, nice inhale to come up. We're gonna swap the crossing. So this time the left leg is gonna go in front of the right leg. You're gonna walk your feet nice and wide. Again, use the height you need. Your knees are nice and level with your hips. You don't need height, that's just fine. Hands on those thighs, nice inhale to lift the chest, shoulders back. Do the rest of the Thoracic Park series, bringing our fingers to our shoulders. Just gently holding onto those shoulders as we inhale to open the arms. Feel like you're holding onto coconuts and squeezing them. Exhale to bring the fingers back to the shoulders. Inhale to open, exhale to close. I'm just really working with that breath. And then bring the fingers to touch the shoulders, bring those elbows forward, gently bringing the elbows towards the wall in front of you, but not to the point where it's jammy. Inhale to open, try and lift your pinky wrist so they're as high as your thumb rest. Exhale to close. Just keep working with that breath. You can see my wrists, my elbows, and my shoulders are ideally in a nice straight line. Fingers to shoulders, let the elbows come down, let the hands come down, shoulders back. Again, just a few deep breaths here. And then we're going to work with that right shoulder. We're going to inhale to lift it straight up by the ear. We're going to exhale to bring it straight down. Inhale it straight up, exhale to bring it straight down. Always listening to your knees, your backs, your hips. You can straighten the leg. It'll also soften the stretch and make it gentler on your knees, back, and hips if you put more height underneath your seat. Just sitting on a blanket or two. And then letting that right shoulder relax down, let's inhale the left shoulder up, exhale down. Inhale up, exhale down.
lower shoulders relaxed. So again, we want to keep a nice long torso, so push your hands into your thighs, lift your chest, shoulders relaxing back. Left leg comes onto the mat beside you. Nice inhale to bring your arm up. And try to keep the straightness from your wrist right down to your hip bone, particularly in this part of your body. We just move to that left side. Try to resist doing this if you can. Root that right hip and reach away from that right hip. And then finding that neutral neck where your ears are equal distance from your shoulders, your ears not too close to your arm, and then you're going to be able to turn your gaze very freely, either down or up. And the less we have this sort of arch, the more we release the hip and the low back on that side. So I like to think about taking my right ribs towards my left ribs and lengthening my left ribs towards my left armpit. And just fixing your gaze. Root the feet so the knees are happy. Root the thighs. Root the seat. Imagine your hand is pushing into a table and it's sliding away from that right hip bone. Again, if it's intense on the shoulder, you can always bend your elbow. And just breathe into that torso. Good, beautiful breaths. And then to come out of this, we're going to bring our gaze down. We're going to really activate our arms and our legs. Nice inhale to come all the way up. Let's bring that right arm down. And this time we rotate it so the thumb points down. We bring the back of the hand to the sacrum, the lowest part of our back. And then bring the other hand on top of it. Root the hands, think shoulders back. Pull the elbows apart, armpits forward. And just let that right ear come down. Those collarbones get really tight when we nurse. Again, the more we can open them up and get them ready for nursing or carrying babies, the better. And then just nice and slow, rotate your chin towards that shoulder. Chin comes back up to center slowly. And then we're just gonna let that opposite ear come down. Continuously breathing. And then rotating your chin towards that shoulder. And chin comes back up to center. And just let that chin come straight down. And then when you're ready, we're going to inhale to lift the shoulders up by the ears. And then out through the mouth. Two more times, just like that. And then hands coming to the knees, lifting the knees, uncrossing your legs, straightening those legs out. Coming onto the center of the heels. Coming off any height that you're on and sitting on the floor. You want to keep a nice straight back. So if you find that your back is doing this, then you need to move your hands further back. It's just fine to be way back here with a straight back. Fingers back is obviously gentler on the wrists. If you're comfortable coming forward, you can come forward. But the whole time, really focusing on that nice straight back. When we arrive there, we're just going to do a little bit of ankle work. Okay, so whether you're here or whether your body's comfortable to come forward, make sure your neck and your shoulders are relaxed. We're right on the center of the heel as we point and flex. So we're not on the outside of that heel. We want to make sure the knees are pointing right up towards the ceiling. So staying centered on that heel. Just pointing and flexing, really working with your breath. And then drawing some big, slow circles. And again, this is just as good. But think shoulders back. You don't want to get in this habit. Stay on the center of those heels. Watch the knees. Keep them pointing up to the ceiling. And change direction for circles.
keep holding onto that imaginary pencil, keeping the foot flexed. And then gradually we're gonna point the foot like a dancer, and then we're gonna flip just the toes back to us. Flex, curl, point, and flip. Flex, curl, point, and flip. One more round. Flex, curl, point, and flip. Beautiful. Spread the toes. And then relax. We're going to come to the insides of the knees. Lift those knees up. Bring the soles of the feet to touch. Knees nice and wide. Again, if you're feeling super tight in your back today, just sit on some blankets. If you feel your knees, bring your feet a little bit closer, or you can also support your thighs with blankets here as well if you're feeling sensitive. Push the feet to one another. I like to make a square, so it's like four 90-degree angles. Grab onto my knees, big inhale. Come forward, starting with a nice straight back, and then gradually just letting your head start to curl. You don't want to put any weight on the inner heels. It's an acupressure point that we want to avoid in pregnancy. We're just coming forward. And eventually you can just let your head hang nice and heavy. My head gently rests sort of in the arches of my foot, but like I said, I don't want any major weight on my heels. You kind of aren't all the way down yet, but if you wanted to add a little bit of height, you could. Just releasing that back. If you're here, you're here. If you're here, you're here. Just being happy with where you're at, knowing every little bit counts. Every little bit helps. And then when you're ready, coming up nice and slow, I'm going to bring those knees together into Shavasana. I like to have at least two blankets between my thighs, like so. Bolsters work great too if you have bolsters. And then one blanket just kind of supporting a neutral neck. And then just spending some time here. Just resting and breathing. Shavasana is the number one most important part of your practice, so making sure you don't skip it. If you've got 10 minutes to stay here for 10 minutes. If you've got 20, stay for 20, but make sure it's at least 3 minutes. And then when your Shavasana is done, using your hands, bringing yourself up with that nice straight spine. And I'll say thank you very much for joining me.